Hey guys, Jonas and
Ashley. Hi.
Welcome back to Vacation Rental 101, all things vacation rentals and second homes here in the Phoenix metro area. Please add, like, subscribe. People don't know about us, so make sure you're subscribing to us. That way we can continue to provide this great content for you guys. Today we're going to be doing a deep dive into what makes a good vacation rental. Certainly not all properties make good vacation rentals.
Nope. So. And we've mentioned this in a previous video, kind of touched upon it, is you can't just put your finger on Metro Phoenix and buy a house in that neighborhood expecting
to... No throwing darts on a map.
Yeah. In this market. So vacation rentals are going to be really dependent upon HOA requirements, kind of the city more or less, whether or not it has a private pool. Like, there's definitely a secret sauce to what makes the best vacation rental, but a lot of it is really budget driven too.
So there's not one way to answer that question. Correct. Ashley hit the nail on the head when she said what makes it budget driven, because if somebody comes in, they're like, what's gonna make a good vacation rental for $300,000? It's gonna be a very different answer than $500,000, $1 million, so on and so forth. So, you know, hate to be redundant, but location, of course. Metro Phoenix is home to over 210 golf courses, shopping, restaurants, bars. We have all the major sports represented here. We have spring training. We have Barrett Jackson, the auto auction. We've got, you know, the Tostito Bowl. We've hosted the Super Bowl multiple times. So people want to be close to, you know, where these things are. So a lot of times people come in with the, you know, with the thought, they're like, oh, I need to buy something in Scottsdale.
Yes.
Scottsdale's great, but how many other places perform equally as well?
You know, actually, what I mean? There's a community out in Goodyear that actually performs better than Scottsdale.
Pound for pound, dollar for dollar.
Yep. Pound for pound, dollar for dollar. And not everybody can afford Scottsdale.
Right.
And really, the city itself is so incredibly saturated with vacation rentals because a lot of Scottsdale is much older, meaning that there's not really, most homes do not lie within an HOA, especially if you're in that old town South Scottsdale area. So in theory, it's fantastic, but in order to get something turnkey and with a private pool, you're looking at $700,000,
$800,000,
and there's a lot more opportunity for us to kind of guide you into where to invest that kind of money if you even have that budget, where you'll actually get better numbers and better performance.
Or if you have a lower budget but want to be Scottsdale, we can look at, you know, townhome, condo projects, that sort of thing too. So that's certainly another option. I think a big part of the answer to the question is also dependent on market, of course. Like, if you're staying in, you know, Hawaii or, you know, California, you're going to want to be, you know, close proximity to the beach. If you're in, you know, Chicago or New York, people want to be in downtown. Those are kind of more unique niche markets because, you know, people want to be right there in the heart of everything. Phoenix Metro is a little different because it's very spread out. There's so many diverse things to do. So the key that we say is you usually want to be within a 30-mile radius of all the things. You want to be 30-minute radius of, you know, the airport, of, you know, the golf, the shopping, the restaurants. So if you're in the heart of, you know, Scottsdale, that's wonderful, but that doesn't mean that other properties aren't going to be great.
Correct.
You know, they have to be marketable. You know what I mean? Like, a huge mistake we see is somebody owns an existing property. It's maybe a residence, or they inherited it, or, you know, they watch HGTV and they just make it look like it's so simple. So, you know, finding unique characteristics that are going to make the property stand out, because if you're going to have competition, there's no problem having competition. You just want to make sure yours is standing out above and beyond the rest, right?
Absolutely. I think too, a lot of people come to us with maybe a little bit of a lower budget and they're not expecting that a condo or townhome is going to be the most budget friendly. They're expecting to buy a single family home without an in-ground pool.
Yep.
That's like a death sentence. If you're going to buy a single family home, it's going to be critical that you either have an existing pool or that you plan on putting one in. And pools right now are really expensive. They've gone up tens of thousands of dollars within the past year, just like our entire market has. So that is the expectation. If you do plan on buying a single family home, that really having a private pool is important. At least 3 beds, 2 baths, at least 1,500 square feet. And in some parts of the valley, that could be $450,000. And in other parts of the valley, it could be well over $1 million.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, kind of the secret sauce magic formula that we see, particularly with the single family homes, not only has to have a pool, has to have a heated pool, or be willing to put a pool heater in.
Critical.
You know, we're the Valley of the Sun, but come winter time, when a lot of the snowbirds are out here, the nighttime temperatures do get low. So the pool's not going to be, you know, swimming comfortable. So you've got electric, you know, heating pool options. You've got gas, you have hybrid, you have solar, you have all those things. Also, when we look at the rent metrics as far as what performs the best for pool versus non-pool, another big one is bedroom count. You know, the jump from a 2 or 3 bedroom property to a 4 or 5 bedroom property yeah. is night and day in revenue.
Very true.
So, and obviously, ideally, you know, a higher bathroom count. Doesn't mean you have to have en suites on all the bathroom, although if you do, it will crush it. But, you know, we want to look for something, good area, marketable, you know, minimum 4 bedrooms if you could swing it. That'll get you the best return. And again, pool or heated pool. Also, furnishings and decor. People cheap out on stuff. Kind of, you get what you pay for. I always say, put yourself in the tenant's shoes. You know, what are they doing when they're looking for properties? They're jumping on these platforms. They're jumping on Airbnb, VRBO. They're looking at videos. They're looking at photos. If it doesn't jump off the page at them, they're not going to stop and take the time of day to do a deeper dive, look at more photos, read the description, that sort of thing. Photos are your fishing lure. That's your yes. bait. So needs to look sexy. You need a great photographer. If the property warrants it, do some drone shots, do some aerial shots, do some community shots. You know, have additional, you know, little, you know, stuff like complimentary golf clubs, pool toys, cornhole sets, stuff like that. People basically want to book where they want a vacation. So if you're chintzing out on everything and it looks like a Motel 6, that's the tenants you're going to attract. That's the rents you're going to attract, right?
It's the honest to God's truth. Yeah. And we talked about this in another video too, your management team. Like if yep. you are expecting to pay someone for white glove management services, but your place looks like you furnished it all from, you know, no name, low yeah. budget. Yeah. yeah, yeah. yeah like, yeah. And it's not to say you can't put right. pieces in there that are older or secondhand or whatever. It's sure. all about design right. and it's about condition.
Right.
If you want to command top rents yep. and have more than 80% of your nights booked, if your property doesn't command eyes, people mm-hmm. aren't gonna book it yeah. regardless yeah. of all the secret sauces right. that we give you. Like it still has to look nice and right. be marketable.
Yeah, and it needs to fit the vibe of the home and the area, yes. right? So if you have a very modern property, say buy a very modern condo, you're gonna want modern furnishings. You know, me personally, I'm not a huge Southwest decor fan, per se, but some of our clients that have opted to do Southwest decor for their home, crush it. You know, people
they
when they're traveling,
very well.
Perform great. People when they're traveling, if you're going to, you know, Hawaii, you want the place to feel like you're in Hawaii. If
yeah.
you're going to, you know, Soho, you know, Chelsea, New York, you want it to feel like you're in the city. Same thing when you're here in Arizona. You know, people are up there in, you know, cold climates and they're just daydreaming about these things. So, you know, spend a couple extra bucks on accessories, pictures, decor, have the amenities, you know, have the right bedroom bathroom count, have the pool, have, you know, logistically close to, you know, where the things that they're going to want to do.
Yeah.
And you'll win.
Yep.
So
absolutely.
That's simple, right?
Yeah. And it goes back to vendors too. If you need help furnishing a yep. property or you need someone on the design side or whatever,
yeah.
reach out to us. We have people that do that. So don't hesitate.
Take it off your plate.
If you feel like
yeah.
you can't put it all together, that's cool. Most people can't.
Yep.
So reach out to us.
Absolutely. So yeah, if there's any additional questions that you may have, topics that we have not covered, if you need contact specifically, maybe you own a vacation rental now, and you just need some great vendors, we're more than happy to share our vendor list, even if you're not a client. You know, we'd love to make you a client, but you know, any value that we can provide, we're always here to help. So make sure you reach out to us. If you, you know, do, it's gonna be, you know, Ashley, myself, and other
yeah.
members of our team that are actually gonna be corresponding with you. So you will be working with us. Until then, we thank you so much for joining us on this video and look forward to providing you additional great content moving forward.
See you later.